This week on Angler West TV, it's a chilly February morning with guide Steve Leonard between the Dalles and Bonneville Dam on the Columbia River with some hopeful anglers going after wintertime keeper sturgeon.
Okay guys, we ran up river here to fish a deep hole that's in here. There's a shelf over here and it's dropping in. We're gonna start out here about 80 feet of water and see what happens.
The Columbia River is world famous for sturgeon, and this area is known for holding good numbers of keeper-sized fish. And then we're with pro angler Bill Townsend fishing Northern California's Whiskeytown Lake for big spotted bass. I'm Justin Wolf, and this is Angler West Television. We're starting off in about 85 feet of water, and in sturgeon fishing, boat position can mean the difference between success and failure.
The sea anchor pulls current on the boat, so when you get a west wind blowing, it pulls tension on the anchor rope in the boat so it keeps everything straight for you so the wind ain't blowing you around. Using smelt and some squid and some shrimp. You never know what they want. So we're gonna try a little bit of everything. Using 20 ounces of lead. Start out here, see what the current's doing. Every day it's a little bit different, so we'll see what the current's doing. We might need to step up to 24s. Right now we're gonna start out with some 20s. Now when you get a bite, it'll be something like this. That's what you're looking for. So just real gentle, pick it up out of here. And you don't wanna lift your rod tip because you can lift this and drop it and you'll feel that weight because this line has no stretch, like 2%. So the more gentle the rope, with the slower water and the cold water, they feel you pick it up, they're gonna drop it. That's right, so keep your rod down.
Feel natural.
That's right. Well, just you don't want to pull it away from because they'll drop the bait. They feel you pick the rod up.
Let them swallow it and suck it down.
Yeah, just and don't let them, when you feel them hitting it and they're pulling on it, then set the hook on it. Sometimes they'll hit and they'll quit. Wait till you feel them hitting and pulling on it. And sometimes even though you're biting in the rod holder, don't just pick it up and set the hook. Pick it up, make sure he's still there before you set the hook. Sturgeon fishing is a lot like halibut fishing. A lot of times it takes just a little bit to get the scent trail going here to draw these fish in or really come in on the scent. It's one of their main key in deals that they have going on, so their eyesight ain't as good. But when you use the Procure scents like we're using with sturgeon cocktails or sturgeon frenzy, some shrimp, just never know what they want, so we try different scents. Once they get on that scent trail, they'll start moving in and hopefully we'll get some bites here. One thing I really like to do is use an injector bottle, because you can inject this inside of the baits, especially on your shrimp and your smelt. And actually we're getting a bite over here right now on it.
I was just gonna say.
And pick that rod up. You feel him hitting it, set the hook. You got him.
Having fun now.
You start getting a hit on that rod, it's this fish getting into it, but you should be okay.
You hit the line probably.
Yeah, so if you do see it, we'll just pick it up out of there, maybe go over the top and we'll see what happens here. Been here for about 15 minutes, so we're on a shelf here. I've been marking a lot of fish on the screen, so sometimes it takes a little bit, but once you get them coming and biting, we should be able to get them going here. One thing I really like about sturgeon fishing is usually you always get some action during the day. You know, you can go out steelhead and salmon fishing and sometimes you get no bites or two or three bites for the day, but good day sturgeon fishing out here, we'll get, you know, 15 to 20 fish, if not more, to the boat. So a lot of action. It's a good time to hang out with buddies and sit on the anchor line, and it's real relaxing, and you get some fish and some action and bites going on during that time. Call this one a shaker. It's an undersize. And where there's shakers, there's bakers. Using a barbless hook, which is required, so it comes out real easy. This fish here is probably a couple feet long, maybe a little bit more. Real prehistoric fish. Their lips come out, and they're feeding on the bottom. Got little whiskers on them. He They got these little scutes on the side that are really sharp. You can go this way and they're not sharp, but if you go against them, they're really razor sharp. It's kind of some protection that they have. As they get older, they wear down a little bit. That's a good fish right there, nursery stock. Real pretty eyes on them. They do a lot of feeding at night also. Real tough fish.
This episode of Angler West TV is brought to you in part by Van Warmer Resorts, Procure Bait Sense, P-Line, and Max High Definition Sunglasses. Welcome back to the Columbia River. I'm Justin Wolf. Gene Ladisal bought this guided trip with Steve Leonard at a fundraiser for a local fisheries enhancement organization, which works towards improving and maintaining the Columbia's incredible sturgeon fishery. On the Columbia, it's not unusual to catch many undersized sturgeon before landing one that falls within the legal size limit.
Get him. Fish on, number two. Woohoo! Sometimes these fish, you never know how big they are. They'll come right to the boat, and sometimes they'll take right off, start peeling line. You just never know. Like it's just not quite big enough. We'll put a measuring stick on it though, just in case. They gotta be 38 inches to the fork of the tail. They changed the way we measure them now, which is actually a good way. So I butt him up against my seat box. Eh, he's 35 inches or so, 36. So, game of inches. Good job, Gene, way to hook him up. A little bit bigger. Yep. A couple inches more and we'll have a nice keeper. These fish, there's a good nursery stock program up here. There's a lot of fish in the river. And these ones here, they grow about 3 to 4 inches a year. Mainly they do most of their growing from May through October, summer months. They feed real heavy. Winter months, they're a little bit more dormant. They don't grow quite as much. So this one here has another year or so to go. For years, we used to be able to go down and get all kinds of smelt. Get 5 gallon buckets fulls, and over the last 5 years or so the run's been getting lower and lower, and this is the first year they've actually shut the smelt season down. So I like to thread these on here to get as much out of them as I can. Usually we just half hitch them all the way out and get one fish out of each bait, but I like to thread them through, do a little half hitch on the end of them. That way you can wrap them with some thread and get 2 or 3 fish out of one bait. It lasts a little bit longer. Take a little thread, just wrap them up a little bit. And then what happens, you get a fish, it'll just cut these half hitches off and this bait will slide up and down your leader, so it'll still save the bait. And you can get a few more fish out of one bait. Put a little sturgeon frenzy inside of him, jacked him up a little bit. Works really good. Ready to go.
Get on that. Oh. Not actually easy.
You're good picking up out of there.
Pick it out?
Yeah.
Get it.
All right. Fish and chips, baby. Ain't nothing better than some fresh sturgeon. Fish and chips.
Yeah, really.
A little beer batter.
Gotcha. Oh, yeah. I got the
good stuff. Just like halibut. A little firmer meat, no bones, nice fillet, white meat. Good stuff.
Wow.
Never know where those keepers are going to be. Wow. Look at this, you guys. Has another bait hanging out of its mouth.
That's awesome.
Yeah. Wow, whole smelt. That just came out of the fish's mouth and he bit our bait.
Oh, good.
There ain't no smelt up here, I wonder. Now, that's bizarre. These fish are hungry. I've seen it down below Bonneville and there's a bunch of smelt coming in, but that was hanging out of its mouth.
Yeah.
Unbelievable.
That's cool.
All right, we're using smelt here and I'm injecting it with some Sturgeon Frenzy, which is a clam-based product. And that's why it works so well up here, is because of the clam base that's in it. And that's what these fish are feeding on up here pretty much year round. The water gets too cold, they go dormant, they don't feed as well. The water temperature's at 38.7 right now. Anywhere from 37 to above, 42 is probably ideal, somewhere in there, but the fish are biting right now. We've had some high water. Flushed them down, cooled it down a little bit, but they're on the bite, so we'll see what happens. But that Sturgeon Frenzy has been a really hot scent to use on this bait. It's swimming. I think he has it on. It's going to jump or it's swimming at us or something. It's on.
Oh, yeah,
it is. We got a double. Two different fish. We got a double on right now. Jim here has a smaller one on, and Gene hooked up on one, and we're not sure how big it is, but we got two on at the same time, so you never know how many bites you're going to get or fish on at the same time. Bring it over here. Keepers are hard to come by. These boomerang pliers, man, they're really nice. They're made out of some aluminum here. Good cutters on them. They don't corrode. A lot of times you get pliers out here, they'll corrode on you. They work really good for unhooking fish and cutting line, whatever you need to do. I deal with a lot of salt water and fresh water, and we test them in the elements out here, and these ones here seem to hold up. Yeah, these fish in this particular section of the river between Bonneville and the Dalles, their main food source is freshwater clams. And then, of course, in the seasons when they're steelhead running and salmon are running, they're spawning, they're feeding on the spawned out fish. Like when the water comes up real high in the Klickitat and the White Salmon rivers and stuff, it floods out a lot of those spawned out dead fish are laying along the shorelines and stuff. So the fish are feeding on it real heavy. Depending on the water temperature, majority of these fish in the summertime months are feeding on freshwater clams in here real heavy. It's their main diet.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
All right. Gene, I think we got one here. That didn't take long. Got these pliers here, a little lanyard string on it, so I never lose them. Works really good for that. It's a good fish we got here. Oh, yeah.
Done deal.
41. 3 inches over. Keep her in the boat.
Awesome.
Just gotta get in the right spot and have all the, a little bit of luck too, you know? It's a nice fish. Nice Columbia River sturgeon.
Really clean.
Yeah, I wanna thank Steve's guide for sponsoring CCA and bought this trip through the CCA banquet. Thanks Steve for hooking us up, so.
You're welcome. A good fish.
Today's episode of Angler West TV is brought to you in part by Shasta Tackle Company, Dove Island Lodge, Caldwell Banker CNC Properties, and Max Lure. Welcome to Whiskeytown Reservoir. I'm Justin Wolf. Just west of Redding, California, Whiskeytown is well known for growing large kokanee, possibly the largest in the state. But it's also one of the West's top big spotted bass producers. Today we're with local bass pro, Bill Townsend.
Not a bad choice, first cast. Doesn't look like a big one, but... That's one thing about these spots. It's not a real big spot, but they're so aggressive, this darn bait's almost as big as he is. That's the first cast in the morning. We got this one. It's not a real big fish, but you know, they're so, these spots in this lake are so aggressive, it's, they'll just eat about just about anything. Right here, we just pulled up on a really, really big hump. And you can see there's a big tower here for the electrical lines and everything. And it's just a monster hump that comes out here and it drops down. It goes over here to another little hump. And it's a known area. Everybody knows about it that fishes Whiskeytown a lot, you know, for big spots. they'll move up on this, you know, to feed and do whatever, and then they'll go back down, and there's a break that runs right down on this one side, drops off pretty deep, and hopefully maybe we'll get a big one off of that. The bait I'm using is this Lunker Punker. It's made by Black Dog Baits, and it's a wood bait. It's very quiet, it's subtle, but you can really make it move, you know, a long distance. You know, like a Zara Spook, you can only move it from side to side, you know, just you know, short ways, maybe 18 inches or 2 feet. If you want this one, you can make really, really super wide swings. You can make it do all different kinds of things. You can make it look like it's slurping, like it's a trout on top of the water, you know, chasing other little bugs or other little fish or anything. But this is really a super bait, especially for these spots on Whiskeytown and Shasta and everywhere else, even for your largemouth, I mean, definitely. But this bait is really cool for the spotted bass. You know, right here where this tower is, it's probably only about 5 or 6 feet right in there right now. Then we have an area that comes out here and drops right down into a big saddle and comes out to another hump over here that's just, oh, I'd say it's 100 yards plus away from us. And we're gonna fish this whole thing out here. It's gonna drop from like 5, 6 feet out here in the middle to saddle. It's gonna be 30, 35 feet, but we're gonna fish that whole saddle and all the way back up into that hump. A lot of times, this time of year, these fish will get out here instead of being on the, up on the shallows, or even on the bottom, they'll get out here and they'll suspend almost right in the middle of these little saddles. And you know, with top water or anything else, even spinner baits or throwing a grub out there, you know, swimming a grub through them, you can catch these suspended fish, and that's what they're gonna be. You know, if they're not up here on top, they'll be out here suspended. And with the full moon that we've had here the last 2 or 3 days, you know, they could have fed up pretty good, you know, during the night, and they could be just out here just relaxing, just taking it easy. Hopefully, you know, maybe we can get some out there suspended. There he is. Not a bad fish. Not a bad fish at all. Oh boy, there's a big one down there with it. There's some good ones. Woohoo! Yes, sir. Oh, there's a fatty. Yeah, look at that. A good Whiskeytown spot right there.
This episode of Angler West TV is brought to you in part by the Boomerang Tool Company, Qualcomm Rivers Winter Harbor Resort, Salmon Trout and Steelheader Magazine, and Trophy Sticks Lures. Welcome back to Whiskeytown Lake. I'm Justin Wolf. Bill Townsend's throwing some big topwater baits and hooking up with some big bass on one of California's lesser-known big bass lakes.
Yeah, look at that. A good Whiskeytown spot right there. There's one 3.5. What a chunk. What a nice looking fish. There he is. You know, all morning we've been fishing humps out here in Whiskeytown. There's just a tremendous amount of humps. And as soon as the sun got on the water, that pattern died pretty quick. So now we're fishing windy banks. We've moved in. And right now, Whiskeytown is always, always gin clear. We're in 22 feet of water, and I can still see the bottom down there, and it's like this all year round. So we're a ways from the bank. We're throwing way out off these points, off these little windy points right here. And this is the first one we fished. We got this one little one, so we'll stay on this for a while and see what happens, see if we can get some better ones. There he is. That's a good fish, I think. He's either a good one or he's foul hooked. Oh, he's pulling pretty good. Yeah, he's foul. Not a bad fish though, another good one. Yeah. Oh yeah, look at that. Another good Whiskeytown spot. Come on. Yeah. Look at that. Look at this fish. This fish has been, at one time it was hit by a boat. That looks just like a prop, went right there across his back, almost severed his backbone, but he survived it. My goodness, I can't believe the gash that fish has got. That's awesome. You know, here it is right now. It's almost a quarter after eight. We've got four topwater fish, end of August. And look at this lake, folks. I mean, I think we've seen one bass boat and one other boat. I mean, this is just pure enjoyment. I mean, look at the country. You couldn't ask for a better place to fish. And this lake compared to like Shasta, Oroville, you know, any of your other spot lakes, this lake here, you have a better opportunity of catching a 20-pound limit here than you do on any other lake, I believe, in Northern California. This lake is absolutely awesome. Not only does it have spots, it has plenty of big largemouth, a lot of smallies. The smallie population is not as good as it was, you know, 10, 15, 20 years ago. But still, I mean, this lake, this fishery is just unbelievable. Let's see if we can catch another one. Oh, that was a good one.
Hey, thanks for watching today's episode of Angler West TV. You know, it's only with the sponsor support that the show is made possible, so please thank them when you can. Now get out there and do some great fishing.